Hi, I'm Ian Small, CEO of Evernote, and I'm here today to talk to you about some of the things we're doing behind the scenes to make your Evernote experience better. In previous episodes, we've talked a lot about the things we're doing with the clients that you use on your phone and on your laptop, things that you can actually see and touch with your own hands. Today, we're going to go up into the cloud to talk a little bit about what we're doing to fix things in our infrastructure. And I'm here with Ankur, a member of our engineering team, who's going to actually explain to us some of what he's been working on. Ankur, what have you been working on to make the experience better?
So one of the things that we have been working on for the last few months has been how do we make our infrastructure more stable and reliable? And I'll give you an example. So what I mean by making the infrastructure stable is, like, if you remember, we had a brownout where our users were having issues for a prolonged period of time connecting or creating, like, notes, syncing their notes, collaborating with the other users and all of that.
I remember things got a bit flaky.
Yes.
Yeah, that's not good. We don't want that.
Absolutely not.
So what are we doing to make it better?
So before we get into, like, what we have done, let's look at what happened at the time, right? So as you can see here are the users.
So these are people with their laptops or their phones or their tablets.
Absolutely. And when they open their app or their desktop and try to create a note or sync or something, they talk to one of the servers that we have in the cloud.
So this is the cloud below the line.
Absolutely.
Okay.
Yes. And when they talk to one of the servers in the cloud, what happens is, like, it has to basically talk to something we call as a user store for making sure the user's identity is the right one and the user is who they are saying they are, kind of a thing. And you can see, like, we have about 750 of the servers, and each of them basically talks to a single user store database.
The same one.
Exactly.
Got it. So 750 talking to one.
Absolutely.
So we can keep... this is a point of contention.
Exactly.
And as our traffic grew, we got to the point where we couldn't find a bigger box to put this on.
We have been doing that for a while now, and about where we are right now is, like, we are on the biggest box we can find.
All right. So if we don't have a bigger box, what do we do?
Yeah. So we can look at what we have done since then.
So this is the after,
yes,
so to speak.
This is the after.
Okay.
And as we started looking at the traffic and everything, one of the trends that we observed was most of our traffic is reading from the database and not so much going and updating the database. So one of the ideas we came up with is, like, oh, if most of that is read, how about we actually create, like, a copy of that database and offload some of the read traffic to some of the copy database we created.
Got it.
So what we call them is, like, read replica. So here we have created three read replicas of the user store database.
So these are exact copies of this database.
Yes. So it's point of time, they were the exact copy, and then we always keep both of the database copies in sync. So anytime this gets updated, we make sure this is replicas are getting updated as well.
So all the reads can go anywhere.
Yes.
But the writes only come to this one.
Exactly.
The service is now more reliable?
How about I show you?
Okay, that's great. So what are we looking at?
So what we have here is all the blue stuff is what the traffic looks like today, or in the current moment.
So this blue area is basically
right.
The traffic on the user store.
Exactly.
What are the red lines and the gray lines?
So what the red line and the gray line shows is, like, what was the traffic on the user store at the exactly same time the previous week and the month before.
So what that's showing is it's this very predictable pattern of what our load looks like. This is across many days, right?
Uh-huh, yes.
And the growth sort of happens slowly over time with some spikes occasionally, but we can model fairly predictably what our traffic's gonna look
yes.
like.
That's correct.
I noticed there's a sharp drop here in the middle of the blue. When was the what's that about?
So that's when the magic happened. So the read replicas that we created, this is a time when we actually deployed them to production. And what you see here is, since the read replica went up and we started diverting read traffic to the replicas, you see the master database getting a really, like, a lower traffic coming to it.
So when did that happen?
Earlier this year, like mid-February.
Oh, months ago. And
yes.
What's going on over here? I notice it goes up and down again. Is that because we turned it off?
Yes. So, like, for a period of time, we had to turn it off for the maintenance purposes and all. And you can see, like, the moment we turned off the replicas, the traffic went up on the master database. And the moment we turned it on again, it went down. So it shows that it works.
So this is remarkable. It looks to me like the traffic's dropped almost 50%.
Yeah, it's between 40 to 50%.
Is this actually going to have a tangible impact on users?
They're already seeing that, because now what they have is, like, the brownout that we had last year. There is less likelihood of that brownout happening, what means that they will continue to be able to use our app, create notes, collaborate with users, and all of that.
So when you do your job right, things don't go wrong.
Yes, but when it goes wrong or when it doesn't work, everybody notices that.
So that's good that you're doing your job right and these things are happening. So that's a little bit of a look of what we're doing behind the scenes to actually fix things up in the cloud in order to make the Evernote that we all use a better and more reliable experience. Thanks very much, Ankur, for joining me and explaining this. Really appreciate it. Hope you've enjoyed it, and we'll see you next time.